voices one of the most beloved characters in all of Star Wars, but that's not all our next guest does. She's also a powerful force in the fashion industry, as well as in... Oh, I gave it away! As well as an advocate for mental health and wellness of people of all ages. Please welcome the voice of Ahsoka Tano, my friend, Ashley Eckstein. The best.
Does it feel so good to be back at Star Wars Celebration?
That's so good to be back. Isn't it just like recharging your batteries?
Oh, I am like fully charged.
It's so good. It's so good to see you. Welcome
you
back.
You as well.
So you've been busy. You're one of the busiest women in Star Wars. What have you been up to lately? You've been, you know, doing her universe. You've been doing your mental health series.
Yes. Well, I, you know what? When Star Wars The Clone Wars Season 7 came out, Ooh. Did you all like Season 7? You know, it came out when we were all at home, which I think was actually the perfect time, because during a really dark time, Star Wars The Clone Wars provided hope. It provided something new that we could look forward to every week in a very unpredictable time. So I'm very grateful it came out when it did, but being at home, I didn't get to go out and meet everyone and hear what you thought. So... I've been doing a ton of conventions and a ton of, you know, meet and greets and getting the chance to, like, make up for lost time.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes. Now, you've seen Ahsoka evolve over the years. What do you think the character has helped... Let me just start that again. Why do you think the character has helped... that you've helped bring to life has resonated with so many fans for so many years now?
Well, I feel very blessed to have originated the role of Ahsoka Tano back in 2008, but she has come so far. Yeah. And I think what has happened now is that Ahsoka lives in all of us. Yeah. She really does. Hi. She lives in our hearts and in our souls. And after almost 15 years of Ahsoka, I mean, it's literally almost 15 years. The ways that she's inspired us, the stories, they live with us. Mm-hmm. And I feel like we take Ahsoka and her inspiration and the hope that she gives us into our everyday lives. And so that's why I used to say Ahsoka lives, just because she lives. But now it's Ahsoka lives in all of us. And I think it's because, yes, yes.
You know, and we've talked so many times about, you know, how Ahsoka has evolved over the years, how she grew up on the Clone Wars, how, you know, her arc and her character grew. But now we're going to start seeing her in live action. Now, what is it like for you to see this character that you have helped create and grow over the years take this next step in their evolution?
I mean, it's incredible to see all of the Ahsoka love. It's absolutely surreal. And I see an Ahsoka out there. Yes.
Yes.
You know, I want you all to know that when you share a story with me, when you come up to my table over there or we talk on social media, it's always a safe space. And I hear you and I see you. And when you share your stories with me of how Ahsoka has changed your life, or in many cases, how she saved your life, that sticks with me. And I think about it, and I remember everyone's stories. And so to be here today, 15 years later, or almost 15 years later, and to see all of the Ahsoka love, and now Ahsoka is getting her own series, and to hear all of your stories, it's just surreal, and it's something I don't take lightly. You know, I might not be your live-action Ahsoka, but I want to be your real-life version of Ahsoka Tano. Thank you. And I promise I wouldn't get emotional, but I really, really care about each and every one of you.
It's so obvious, right?
And I just, I, th- thank you. And I'm just honored to be here 15 years later celebrating Ahsoka with all of you. Thank you.
Ashley.
Thank you.
And obviously, the love is very much mutual.
Thank you.
So when we're talking about, you know, Rosario coming on and helping to build onto this character and you know, help her expand, was there any specific guidance or advice that you gave her about, you know, being a good steward of this character?
You know what? That's a great question, because I've never actually met Rosario.
Oh, snap.
We've never met. We've never spoken. But it's a dream of mine. And so I talk about throwing your dreams out into the universe. And it would be an absolute dream to meet her one day. It would be a dream to do a cameo on the Ahsoka series. It would be an absolute dream. So, hopefully one day it'll happen. And I know it will. And I would love to meet Rosario. We're all part of Team Tano. We are one Team Tano. And I can't wait.
So you've also been writing a lot of books. Can you tell us about, you know, your new books that have been coming out?
Yes. Well, you know what? I am so, so grateful for the platform that Star Wars has given me. And like you've now heard me blubber and cry up here, I don't take it lightly. I take it very seriously. And so I've had the chance to write a couple books now. One we're gonna announce tomorrow. It's called Star Wars Every Day. And it comes out in October. It's a lifestyle book on how to live your best Star Wars life all year long. Thank you. And thank you very much. And one thing I'm very, very, very proud of, because it's a passion project that I've worked on for 5 years now. And so one lesson that Ahsoka's taught me is patience. Lots and lots of patience. But I launched a new video series called Star Wars Mindful Matters.
It's so good.
Thank you.
It's so good. Have you guys been watching?
Thank you. So they're just 2 to 3 minute short videos where I get to teach mindful lessons. And they're the mindful lessons that we learn from Star Wars. So it's our favorite, you know, our favorite characters from Star Wars teach us these lessons. But I teach how you can do them too. So I share exercises, and they're clinically based mindfulness exercises. But they're on the Star Wars Kids YouTube channel and StarWarsKids.com. But I want to preface that they're for everyone. We put them on the kids page because we want parents to know that these videos are safe for kids to do, because our kids need to learn these lessons now more than ever. We've all been through a really rough 2 years, but so have our kids. And so they're on the Star Wars Kids YouTube channel and StarWarsKids.com, but they're for everyone, because Star Wars is for everyone, right? So Jedi Master Yoda teaches us that it's just as important to train our mind as it is to physically train our body. And so Star Wars Mindful Matters teaches us the mindful lessons that we learn from Star Wars. And please watch them. Please share them. I think these lessons are more important now than ever.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's a really, really lovely series.
Thank you.
It's been really fun to watch. And we can't have you up here and not talk about her universe, because her universe has been such a game changer for so many young fans, and now it's such an established part of the fandom. I mean, how many young girls out there have come up wearing her universe? Yes. And now, and you know, and so it's for everyone. So what's new?
Yes.
What's coming up for her universe?
Well, it started as her universe, and we also have our universe now, because Star Wars is for everyone. But we got to launch a brand new collection today. It's called From the Archives, and it's because we got to go to the archives at Skywalker Ranch.
I am so jealous. I have been trying to get in there for years.
We got to see all of the original costumes from the original trilogy and the prequels. And we got to see them in person. We got to see them right up close. And in some cases, we got to touch them. The Lucasfilm Archives team just showed us all the costumes up close. We got permission from George Lucas himself to do this collection. And so all of this collection, which the Her Universe booth is right there through the center, right to the right, and there's pieces for women and for men and unisex, but all of the collection, the entire collection, is inspired by the archives. So what I'm wearing is actually Princess Leia's vest that she wears on Endor in Star Wars Return of the Jedi. Yes, so these sleeves and this hood actually zips off, and we have an Endor pattern with Ewoks in it.
I love that.
But then check out this shirt that I'm wearing. This is Ahsoka on a Lothwolf. I don't even know if Dave knows that we made this shirt, but I don't know if he knows that this piece of art that he sketched is actually in the archives. So when you pull out the Clone Wars drawer in the archives, there's this sketch from Dave Filoni. So there's this unisex t-shirt up there, and we have so many pieces, and a lot of Padme pieces. We're showing a lot of love for Padme. She deserves some love. But we have a Boba Fett top, a Han Solo top, so many amazing things. This is a limited collection. So if you see something you like, go get it. It's called From the Archives, and it's available now.
I'm going to come over and raid your booth. Well, thank you so much, Ashley, for coming up here. And Andy, thank you so much for everything that you've done for the Star Wars fandom, for the universe. It's just been, you know, such a joy to get to know you over the years and see the power that you have in this community. It's really, really incredible.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
All right, guys. And what I do know is that there was going to be so much more Star Wars Celebration Live 2022 from Anaheim coming up in just a minute. Don't go anywhere. And give it up for Ashley one more time.